Hi, I'm Jim Covington. Today is March 19, 2015. I'd like to welcome you to this week's issue of ISBA Statehouse Review. I have five pending bills to talk to you about and a budget issue that's not yet in bill form, but is certainly dominating the attention of the four legislative leaders and the governor. And that specific issue is the shortage in the court reporter funding, the current budget shortage in the Department of Corrections budget, and the shortage in the child care assistance program. Their designees are meeting to try to find a solution to those three issues, which we hope is sooner than later, because as many have pointed out, the a shortage or laying off of court reporters has a direct consequence on the detention in the county jails, the logjam for those awaiting trial, and there's possible, you know, speedy trial implications with that as well, so we hope that's a resolution is sooner than later. The first bill I'd like to talk to you about is House Bill 2456, introduced by Representative Dwight Kay from Glen Carbon. It amends the Code of Civil Procedure to allow the court the discretion that if the court grants or denies in whole or in part a motion to dismiss because of a absence of a basis in law or fact for the action, then the court may award cost and reasonable and necessary attorney's fees to the prevailing party in amounts that court deems equitable and just. That is scheduled for hearing next Wednesday in House Judiciary Civil Committee. The next bill is House Bill 3518, introduced by Representative Robert Martwick of Chicago. It amends the Code of Civil Procedure to define what is a product liability action and a confidentiality order for those. And it goes in and sort of sets out a framework of how those are released, what's in them, how to draft those things. And I've gone into much more detail in the written materials that are attached to this podcast. That's scheduled for hearing next Wednesday in House Judiciary Civil as well. The next bill I'd like to talk to you about, which was scheduled for this morning in House Counties and Township Committee, is House Bill 3672, introduced by Representative Greg Harris from Chicago. It allows a county recorder in a county that has a property fraud alert system to create a registration form to register a property owner on the county's property fraud alert system and allows a real estate professional to file with the recorder on behalf of a property owner. And that is scheduled for hearing this morning. I'm not sure what the outcome that was. If it wasn't taken action this morning, it'll be scheduled for next Thursday in that committee. The next bill is House Bill 2569, introduced by Representative John Cabello from Rockford. And it lists about 6 to 7 things that a trial judge must explain to a defendant before he or she can take a guilty plea from the defendant. And it goes into much more detail than I think what is being done now. It may mirror case law, I'm not sure. The maximum minimum penalty provided by the law, any possible increase in sentence by reason of the fact of a prior conviction. I've itemized those in your written materials that are attached to this podcast. And that is passed out of House Criminal Law Committee and is on second reading in the House. The fifth and final bill I'd like to talk to you about is House Bill 3744, introduced by Ron Sandak from Downers Grove, and it creates the Notice and Opportunity to Repair Act. And it requires the service of notice by a homeowner to a construction professional of alleged defects in the construction before the homeowner can commence a lawsuit. And it allows the professional to make an offer or settlement and to rescind the offer if the claimant fails to respond within 30 days. It requires the claimant to file with the court a list of known construction defects. And it directs the professional to provide a statutory notice to the homeowner upon the execution of a contract. And that is scheduled for House Judiciary Civil next Wednesday morning. Thank you for listening, and I'll see you next week.